Well, in the previous video, we discussed how the princely state Junagadh became India's integral part. Today, we are discussing about Hyderabad, that how Hyderabad became India's integral part. Hyderabad was also ruled by the prince. He was the Nizam of Hyderabad. And you know, this person was one of the richest men of the world. And this state, Hyderabad, was the largest princely state. He never wanted to be a part of India or Pakistan. He wanted to govern his state on his own. On the other side, the Indian government, especially Sardar Patel, he was trying to convince him to be a part of Indian state. So ultimately he said okay. He wanted exactly some time. So he signed an standstill agreement, that let the things stay as it is at least for 1 year. And this agreement he signed in November 1947. We got freedom in August. So August, September, October, and in November 1947, he signed the standstill agreement, that at least for 1 year, he wanted to grab time actually. He wanted Hyderabad to be an independent state. Anyhow, people of this state were not happy with this Nizam. He was against Nizam's rule. Especially the peasants. Especially the women. Why? Because they were very oppressed. They were very oppressed. So they came out on roads. They had some movements and people came out in large number, the peasants of the state, Telangana region, because he was a very oppressive ruler. So they took voice against him. They came out in the streets of Hyderabad in very large number, and a huge movement was against him. So Nizam wanted to curb them. Uske paas na paramilitary forces thi iski khud ki. He had some paramilitary forces, and what were they known as? Razakars. What were they known as? Razakars. So to curb the movement, he asked them, his paramilitary forces, that these activities should be stopped. And these Razakars, they were so cruel that they murdered, they maimed, they raped, they looted, they targeted people, especially the non-Muslims, because he himself was a Muslim. ठीक है, so the central government जो इंडिया का था, they had to order the army to tackle this situation. His people were on one side, his Razakars, they were so cruel that they were doing the atrocities against them. So the Indian government had to order for the army to tackle the situation. And you know, in September 1948, the Indian army moved to control the Nizam's forces. And finally, after few days, Nizam surrendered. And then he signed the agreement of accession, that now I agree to become a part of Union of India. So this was how Hyderabad became the part. Now, Manipur. Manipur again, the prince, the king was Maharaja Bodhachandra Singh. He was the ruler. He was the ruler there. Maharaja Bodhachandra Singh also was not ready to sign the instrument of accession. But the public, the people of Manipur pressurized, and in June 1948, वहाँ पे elections कराए जाते हैं. June 1948 में elections कराए जाते हैं, and Manipur became the first Indian state to hold elections on the basis of universal adult franchise. So after the elections, Manipur becomes a constitutional monarchy. मतलब monarchy तो रही, महाराजा का रोल रहा, but because people, they elected their representatives, so they formed constitutional monarchy over there, and then merge हुआ, agreement sign हुआ, और this was how the princely state of Manipur became the integral part of Indian Union. Fourth state is Kashmir. Maharaja Hari Singh was there. Now this particular state we have a special explanation in forthcoming chapters. So this particular state, the fate of this particular state, we will be discussing in that chapter in details. So this third chapter, topic of your first chapter, that is integration of princely states, is over after discussing these three states. This one, Kashmir, we shall be discussing in that particular chapter. Why? Because certain more things which are required here that are being explained in that chapter. So in the next video we shall be discussing the fourth chapter. Keep on listening this video again and again. Take care of your health, listen to the parents, obey the orders of the government, and stay home. Thank you.